So, you've decided to spice up your lifestyle and embark on a weight loss journey. You've heard about intermittent fasting, IF, the popular trend for weight loss, and it piqued your interest. But what exactly happens to our body when we practice intermittent fasting? Why is it seemingly easier to limit eating hours rather than the quantity of food? In this video, we'll delve into the science behind IF and reveal the potential transformation your body may undergo after 30 days of intermittent fasting. What is intermittent fasting? Let's start with the basics. Intermittent fasting, or IF for short, is an eating pattern that cycles through periods of food consumption and fasting. Unlike other diets, such as the keto or paleo diet, that emphasize the type of food consumed, IF focuses on the timing. Instead of following a traditional three-meal-a-day schedule, intermittent fasting typically involves extending the fasting period between meals or skipping certain meals altogether. There are several methods or approaches to IF schedules, and these include the 12, 14, 16, 18, or even 24 hours of fasting. Each of these numbers represents the fasting duration in a 24-hour period. For example, a 16-hour fast would mean that you eat all your day's food within an 8-hour window and fast for the remaining 16 hours. But how do you decide which schedule is right for you? For beginners, it's often recommended to start IF with a 12-hour fasting schedule. This usually involves restricting food from 10 p.m. to 10 a.m. the next day. Over time, many adapt to this eating routine and gradually increase their fasting duration, such as fasting from 6 p.m. to 11 a.m. the following day. One of the benefits of IF is its flexibility to fit into our daily lifestyles, allowing us to maintain consistent eating patterns without major disruptions. If you start work early in the morning, you can plan your meals throughout the day so you feel less hungry before bedtime. The same principle applies to those working late night shifts. Does intermittent fasting work? Now that we have covered the basic hourly routines, let's tackle the question everyone wants to know. Does IF actually work? Or is the reported weight loss contributed to something else? Well, the scientific consensus on this isn't entirely clear. As our aim is to provide accurate information to our audience, we will present a balanced view by exploring both perspectives of the argument. In a 2019 study published in the New England Journal of Medicine titled Effects of Intermittent Fasting on Health, Aging, and Disease, neuroscientist Dr. Mark Mattson investigates the effects of IF on aging, weight loss, and disease prevention. According to the authors of the 2019 publication, IF, characterized by alternating periods of feeding and fasting, triggers adaptive cellular responses that improve glucose regulation, stress resistance, and inflammation suppression. Or in simpler terms, IF helps your body utilize sugar better, reduce stress, and reduce inflammation. These new onsets of responses then further aid the processes of cell and tissue repair and growth. Dr. Mattson further explains the impact of intermittent fasting on metabolic switching, which is the process where our body stops using sugar and switches to using fat as fuel. As shared by Dr. Mattson, intermittent fasting contrasts with the normal eating pattern for most Americans, who eat throughout their waking hours. If someone is eating three meals a day, plus snacks, and they're not exercising, then every time they eat, they're running on those calories and not burning their fat stores. To put it simply, when we limit the hours of food consumption, our bodies begin to utilize stored sugars and fats for energy. During fasting, triglycerides are broken down into fatty acids and glycerol, which are converted to ketone bodies by the liver. Ketone bodies become a significant source of energy, particularly for the brain. We burn fat in order to meet our daily energy needs. In studies of weight loss related to IF fasting, the bulk of the studies, including the 2019 publication by Dr. Mattson, tend to highlight studies involving overweight and obese subjects or animal subjects. However, there is less than sufficient evidence on the impact of IF on healthy, non-obese individuals seeking to lose weight. The absence of proven weight loss results on healthy individuals is the core reason for the controversy surrounding intermittent fasting. Recent 2023 studies aim to discover the truth behind IF powers report certain limitations to this diet and eating pattern. In a study involving 550 adult participants over a period of 6 years, researchers from Johns Hopkins University discovered that meal timing had no significant effect on weight change, as reported by Dr. Wendy Bennett, the senior author of the study. Although experimental studies have suggested that time-restricting eating could improve circadian rhythms and play a role in metabolic regulation, our study did not detect an association in a population with a wide range of body weights. Here's what to expect with intermittent fasting. So, with all of this information in mind, can our bodies experience an incredible transformation after 30 days of intermittent fasting? Many testimonials of dedicated IF followers share their experience on the habitual side of this diet. Remember, these are all anecdotal and not scientific evidence. Some people find it more convenient to adopt the habit of ending their daily eating at a fixed time rather than engaging in the complexities of tracking calories or limiting specific nutrients. Others prefer to stay less physically active while strictly adhering to an intense and structured 18-hour fasting window. Remember, not everyone enjoys hitting the gym, and that's perfectly fine as well. Intermittent fasting, like fashion trends, should be taken with a grain of Himalayan pink salt. While scientific research is still catching up on validating the weight loss benefits of IF, there is a potential for time-restricted eating habits to align with specific lifestyles. The key is to do the necessary research before starting intermittent fasting, and to listen to how your body reacts to the new change. If you have any experiences with IF, comment down below what you think of it. Thanks everyone for watching. If you learned something new today, consider subscribing and comment down below what you want us to explore next.